Alright, how's it going, everybody, and welcome back to the Aston Villa Career Mode, Episode 2. And in the last episode, we did make some offers for a lot of players. Let's actually take a look at that. Transfer negotiations. And look at the transfer for sent. Yeah, just look at it. So many players we've offered for. And I asked you guys for some player suggestions. And right here, I have one from Bobby Bratton Carp Fishing. And he told me to look at James Ward-Prowse, and I was like, that's a very good shout, because obviously James Ward-Prowse is a very good talent from Southampton, and yeah, right there he is. So put him on my shortlist. I'm currently scouting him, and we'll see what he looks like, how much he will cost us, but I think he could be a very good player for us. So looks like Lille wants to steal one of our players, Douglas Coutinho. Not sure how much we offered. So we offered 1 million, Lille offered 1.7. So we're just gonna up our offer to 1.8 million because I don't want anybody stealing our transfer targets. My goodness, everybody wants Douglas Coutinho, look at that. Especially the French teams, but we offered more than 1.7 million, so they should accept our offer. Wow, that's a shitload of emails, so let's get through one by one. So it looks like Charlton Athletic have accepted our transfer offer for Tony Watt. And let's offer him a contract. We can always decline the offer at the end. Just put important first team player in, which he's obviously not gonna be. God damn it. Alright, so we can do it again. So via the transfer negotiation menu, you can offer a new contract or other contract in case you mispressed anything. So I think for now, let's offer him, I don't know, sporadic first team player maybe? QPR rejected offer for Charlie Austin for 3.5 million because he's too valuable to them. So, you know what? I think I want to get rid of Libor Kozak. And I think we could put him in this deal. I mean, he has a value of 3 million. So, maybe Kozak and 1.5 million? I think it could be a good deal. Burnley have accepted our offer for Michael Keane, so let's offer him a contract. That is very exciting. And maybe he's going to take a squad rotation player, I don't know. Wow, two more teams that want Douglas Coutinho, and they offer 1.9 million, so I think I should offer 2 million now. I mean, surely he must be a good player if literally every single team in Europe wants him. So Wolves told me they do want some more money for Iorfa. And I decided to put in Hutton in this deal. He is worth 1.5 million. He's 30 years old, so he's not going to have that much of a future. And it would be a right back for right back swap. And I put also 200k in there. So Lech Poznan wants a lot of money for Karolinity. Look at that, 3.4 million. I'm not sure if I'm ready to pay that amount of money. At least not right now. Everton won 1.3 million for Brandon Galloway, which is quite a lot. Let's try for 900k. Also, Dundee United rejected offer for Charlie Telfer. But since we're looking at James Ward-Prowse now, I don't think we need him necessarily. So let's leave that for now. Wow, again, a ton of emails. So let's first go to this one for Viktor Kovalenko. Because I think he could be a great, great player. And I think we could sign him up as a sporadic first team player. I think he would get a few appearances because he has some very nice stats. The offer for Rodrigo Dorado was accepted, I think like 2.5 million. So let's offer a contract for now and see what's going to happen. So Celta Vigo want 11 million for Nemanja Radoja. And I know why, because he's a very good player. So let's try for 10 maybe. I don't know, that's a lot of cash, but we could definitely need him. Ipswich did decline the offer for Teddy Bishop. However, now I'm gonna offer 700k and Jarrell Sellers and see what they're gonna say. Brighton straight up declined my offer for Christian Walton. So now I'm gonna offer Benjamin Sigrist and 500k maybe. Let's see what they're gonna say. So apparently Bolton won 1.3 million for Zach Clough. And let's offer 1 million for now because that's quite a lot of money for a 66 overall. Pachuca did decline our transfer for Eric Gutierrez, and I'm not sure if I really, really need him. So let's leave that for now. Wow, QPR want 10 million for Charlie Austin. That is ridiculous. You know what? I think the best thing to do right here is, because he only has 1 year remaining on his contract, let's just wait until January and sign him up for free for next season. I think that's way better than spending 10 bloody million on him. However, the transfer for Douglas Coutinho was accepted, and now let's offer him a contract 25 million and squad rotation player. Wolves have accepted my offer for Iorfa, and now let's offer him a contract. Maybe he's gonna take squad rotation player, I hope so. So Everton want 1.3 million for Brendan Galloway. I'm not sure. I'm really not sure if that's, if he's really worth that much. Let's try 1 million more. Again, a ton of emails. So Tony Watt has accepted a contract offer. I think he could be a very nice player to have. He's English, he's still quite young and could grow into a really good player. Also, Michael Keane accepted a contract offer, which is very good to see. He's gonna get some regular playing time. And we have another one, Viktor Kovalenko accepted. And there we go! Already 3 signings in, just like that. And we still have 29 million to spend. Celta Vigo have accepted a contract offer for Nemanja Radoja. And I am very excited about this. Bolton have accepted for Zach Clough. So let's offer this contract and give him sporadic first team player. Hopefully he's gonna join us, because he could grow into a very good player. So let's take a look at the new boys. Here we have Watt, who is quite pacey but also has very good strength and good finishing at 72 and 74 shot power. Those are some very decent stats for a 21-year-old. Michael Keane is a quality centre back, 75 strength, and also very good tackling. Not necessarily very good, but pretty damn solid, 73 and 74. And also, he's not the slowest, which is very good. And he is 6'2", so very good size for centre back. And he can play right back as well. And here we have Kovalenko. He can play anywhere in the centre department of the field. Just overall good, solid stats. And I think this FIFA is a lot about balance. And this guy has it, and he's only 19 years old, so he's only gonna get better. So Rodrigo Dorado has accepted a contract offer, and I think he could be a very good CDM to grow, so come on lad, get in there. So Ipswich still don't want to give away Christian Walton, so let's wait on that offer. But Teddy Bishop has accepted a contract, and again, very good young talent, in my opinion, and he could be a great one in 2 or 3 years. Taking a look at Rodrigo Dorado, he's a very tall, unfortunately not very strong CDM, who can pass the ball very well. Just look at that 80 short passing, and also 76 long passing. So he's more like a playmaking CDM, but I think he's gonna be very good for us. So we got another training session here. As you can see, I've put some of the new guys in there, actually 4 of them. Let's see how they're gonna do in their first training. Look at Keane getting an A on 1-2 defending. Nobody's gone up yet, but still some decent performances besides Kovalenko and Dorado. So meanwhile, I got like 10 emails of other clubs trying to sign Douglas Coutinho, but he's gonna be ours, and I'm very excited about that. He must be good. I mean, literally, I never had that there were actually like 10 clubs who want a player who's on my shortlist. And there we go, Dominic Iorfa is also gonna join us. Very excited about that. And you guys were probably wondering why I'm so high on this guy. Just look at that. Fast, good strength. Maybe his tackling needs a bit of work. 73 is decent. Needs also, he's not very good at ball, which is a bit unfortunate. But he's 6'4" as a right back, and he's so freaking fast. And I mean, we can make him better on the ball. Surely we can with training. So I'm very excited to have him on our team. And let's take a look at Coutinho, 70 overall striker. Also, rather pacey player with not much strength, but 77 dribbling and 74 finishing, which is outstanding. And he can also play as a right mid, and he has 4-star skill moves and is only 21 years old. So James Ward-Prowse is now fully scouted, and just looking at his stats, there's no way we can't make an offer for him. Hopefully it's not gonna be too much. Are you serious? Only about 5 million for him. That is crazy. Nemanja Radoja has accepted a contract offer, and he's gonna cost us 10 million, which is quite a lot. But he's probably going to be worth it. There we have him. He's a very good passer, and he can tackle quite well. Perfect CDM with a good height at 6'1" as well. And he can also play as a center mid. There's no way I could pass on him. And Everton have accepted for Brandon Galloway, and that's quite weird. He wants 4.8k salary. Usually they always want like 4, 5k. They never want anything in the hundreds, but works, I guess. 5 years, future first team player. Maybe we'd have to loan him out at first. Zach Lau has accepted our contract offer, and he's going to be the next signing coming in, a cam for the future. Well, look at that. Southampton accept right away for James Ward-Prowse. He only wants a bit more money. 5 years. Maybe he's going to take squad rotation player. Brighton just don't want to give us Chris Walton. This is ridiculous. Let's just offer the money. And there's another new signing, Teddy Bishop. Get in the team. And another one, Brandon Galloway. Welcome to Aston Villa. So Brighton have got an offer from MK Dons over 900k. So just to be sure, I'm going to offer them 1 million, which is a bit more. James Ward-Prowse wants a bigger squad role, so let's give him important first team player, which he is probably going to be because he's very decent. Another training session, so let's simulate that and see how our player's going to do. So, wow. Nobody better than a C. Alright, so it looks like Sheffield are gonna take Benjamin Siegrist on a 1 year loan, which I'm glad, because he's not gonna play, that's simple as that. My goodness, Brighton are so stingy, let's just offer them the 1.3 million. And there is James Ward-Prowse joining our team, I'm so excited about that. Yes! Norwich offer for Felipe Senderos. I think I'm gonna count off of 1 million. Oh, finally, Brighton. Fucking finally. And what is with these weird player demands? 4,550. I've never seen that before. That is so weird. Another training session. Let's simulate them all and see what happens. So Grealish this time gets a B. His short pass. He's getting up and looks like he's gonna be a 73 overall. Very, very soon. Other than that, nobody doing too well. So it looks like Norwich don't want to pay more than 800k, which is fair enough. Senderos, he's already 30 years old, and he's not going to be growing, of course. And I think getting rid of him is just the right move, because we have a good few centre-backs, and you're not going to get Brad Guzan just yet. So I wanted to include the season opener against Bournemouth in this video as well, but I think we've spend already way too much time. I mean, how many players have we signed? Let's check right here the transfer negotiations, because I couldn't keep count. So far we've made 11 transfers in this video. That surely is a record, isn't it? And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what you call squad death. Just look at that, how many players we have right now. I think I'm trying to get rid of a few players, especially those right here, maybe Gardner Richardson, maybe Cole, because he's not gonna be very useful, I don't think. But look at that. Those are all players that could get some playing time with us. And it's just ridiculous that some of them are on the reserves, like Keane and freaking Akbon Lahore and Gay as well. That's just absolutely amazing. But I wanted to put Kovalenko on the bench. Maybe gonna change that as well, but we've got Ward-Prowse in the starting 11 now, and also we have where is he? Radoa there at CDM, which is just very nice. As a backup striker, I decided to go with Coutinho. Of course, in Barca's Premier League, you do need squad depth, and we do have that right now, especially a lot of very young talent. But yeah, let's see what players we're going to get rid of. Hopefully we can get rid of Kozak, because I don't think he's going to be in my future plans. So anyways, next episode we're going to start off the Barclays Premier League season. And I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.